all the links in that chain, those folks would have been lost. If just one had broken, they could have been drowned. Ladies and gentlemen, in the Church of Jesus Christ, you and your service and your participation is critically important. And without you, someone may be lost. How exciting to be part of that chain. A couple of years ago, I bumped into a gal in a touch a truck with a gigantic smile on her face. Before I could even ask what it was that she was so happy about, she started telling me all about helping the kids and seeing the families delight, distributing Bibles and everything we were giving away. She went on and on. It was one of her first serving opportunities, and she couldn't get over how satisfying it was, how much fun she had, and how many people she had gotten to know in such a short time. "I'm just sorry it's over," she told me. "I can't wait for the next time to do something like that." My hope and my prayer is for everyone at First Baptist to experience that kind of joy, fullness, and belonging. So I'd like to introduce a little bit of a thought to you, kind of a new tool to help you discover your heart for ministry. If you look closely at Acts 6, you'll notice that the leaders didn't just ask for volunteers or choose the first warm bodies they could find. They thoughtfully chose people who were uniquely suited for that particular ministry. These people were empowered by the Spirit. They had a heart for the ministry. In the same way, we'd like to help you find the particular areas of ministry for which God has equipped you, because we know that's where you'll be more effective and where you'll find the most joy and fulfillment. Shortly, we'll be sending out participation cards. Pray about your involvement. Fill out that card. Turn it in. We need you. We'd like you to approach responding to these opportunities for participation with the following mindset. Think of the word heart. H stands for heart, your personal passion for ministry. What excites you? What breaks your heart? What dream or problem keeps you awake at night? Maybe you're particularly engaged and interested in developing something for children or teenagers or young moms or seniors. Maybe you have a concern for the poor, people with special needs. Maybe you have a heart for prayer or missions. We want you to find your passion for ministry and share it. E in the word heart stands for experience. Positive and negative experiences that have shaped your life and faith. Nothing that's happened to you in life is wasted. If you offer it to God, He'll make something of it. If you've suffered a loss in your life and you've experienced God's comfort, you may be well equipped to share that with someone else who's dealing with grief and loss. If you were blessed by a great youth group and you want to help provide some similar experience to this generation, ask how God wants to turn your life into a ministry for others. And the word heart, A, stands for anointing, your spiritual gifts. What God has given to you, that if you begin to engage those gifts, you're going to be especially blessed, and the church will be especially blessed because of it. R stands for relationship. How are you wired relationally? Do you like to work alone or with a team? Are you more of a leader or a follower? If you're good with people who visit or connect easily with people in social settings, you might be a great greeter. On the other hand, you're better at deeper relationships with a few people, then maybe starting a small group or mentoring would be best for you. So you need to know what your relational style is. And then the word heart, T, stands for talent, your natural skills, your education, your professional expertise, even a hobby you might have. God didn't give you those talents or interests just so you could make a living or just have fun. He wants you to use them for the kingdom. Ministry isn't just about Bible teaching and evangelism. If you've got technical skills, IT skills, there's all kinds of areas to serve. Think through these categories. They can help you identify your heart for ministry and give you fruitful and a satisfying place to serve. It's important, not just for the church, but it's important for you personally. You see, in God's math, ladies and gentlemen, plenty minus one does not equal enough. We need you. One of my favorite Christian authors, Bob Benson, who's been with the Lord for quite a while now, wrote about the experience of taking one of his children to college for the first time. If you haven't been there, you might still identify with this, because this is an important human experience. Listen to what he says. Nearly a week ago, Peg and I had a very hard week. Wednesday night, Mike slept downstairs in his room where children belong, and we slept upstairs in ours where moms and dads belong. Thursday night, we were 350 miles away, and he was in Ramada 325, and we were in 323, in connecting rooms, and we left the door open and talked and laughed together. Friday night, 700 miles from home, and he was in 274, and we were in 279, and it was just down the balcony, and somehow we seemed together. Saturday night, he was in the freshman dorm, but we were still in the motel room. And Sunday night, we were home, and he was 700 miles away, Chapman 309. Now, we have been through this before. Robert had gone away to college, and we had gathered ourselves together until we had gotten over it, mainly because he's married now and he only lives 10 miles away and comes to visit often. So we thought we knew how to handle separation pretty well, but we came away so lonely and blue. Our hearts are filled with pride at a fine young man, and our minds are filled with memories from tricycles to commencements. But deep down inside, somewhere, we just ached with loneliness and pain. Somebody said, you still have three at home. Three fine kids, and there's still plenty of noise, plenty of ball games to go to, plenty of responsibilities, plenty of laughter, plenty of everything, except Mike. And in parental math, 5 minus 1 just doesn't equal plenty. And I was thinking about God. He sure has plenty of children. Plenty of artists, plenty of singers and carpenters and candlestick makers and preachers. Plenty of everybody except you. And all of them together can never take your place. And there will always be an empty spot in his heart and a vacant chair at his table when you're not home. And if once in a while it seems as if he's crowding you a bit, try and forgive him. And maybe one of those nights when he misses you so much, he can hardly stand it. We need you involved in the ministry of this church as we move forward in doing the Lord's work.